At this time, I've met with my brother from Africa, and he's also here busy. He's just a very young man here, and I think he's also just good for us to have an interview with him regarding to homelessness issues in Vancouver, and why Vancouver might be expensive place to live, and his view about the issues of homelessness and affordable housing, issues of free food, food and income, just people to survive here in the city, East End, Strathcona and Hastings. Why is it this city, after so many years, this side, East Side, is still become the worst, the most place with the high rate of poverty, unemployment issues, and not only that, but the issues of homelessness. Mayor, Mr. Robert Gurigua, the mayor, His Lordship Mayor Robert, 2008, Mr. Robert said that by 2015, he made the commitment that homelessness will be a forgotten dream. But today we still see that homelessness is increasing. The issues of affordable housing is become a very hard issues in Vancouver. And then we have seen that the mayor is struggling to stand for his commitment. But the fact is that Mr. Robert, Mayor Robert Gurigua, has still committed to deal with the issues of homelessness in Vancouver and affordable housing. Recently, when Mr. Mayor Robert Gurigua swearing at downtown Vancouver, he made it very clear that he's still committed to deal with the issues of homelessness on the street. Homelessness on the street, street homelessness will be a forgotten dream by 2015. So, I'm here standing today with my brother to share this dream.
Okay, what I would like to talk about the issue you just mentioned, yeah, about homelessness.
Yeah.
There is the homelessness. I'm homeless right now.
You're homeless right now?
Yeah.
You are homeless right now?
I am homeless. I'm a good looking boy.
Yes.
I'm young guy.
Yeah.
I have never when I go on my wall.
Yes.
Nobody would even think I'm homeless. You know, but again, I'm homeless.
So if you go to your Facebook wall, people they think that you this is a handsome man.
I know. Because I do this of my dignity. Just to honor my dignity, you know.
Yes.
But when it comes to truth, I'm homeless right now.
So you are homeless right now.
I've been homeless for 2 months.
You have been homeless for 2 months,
yeah,
right now.
I don't have no home. I've been sleeping with a friend, and sometimes I get kicked. Like tonight.
Yeah.
I try go to my friend's house.
Yeah.
Who I often used to go sometimes.
Yeah.
And He didn't open it to me, and I'm right now. I didn't sleep since last night. I'm telling you.
Yeah.
My eyes are open from the other night, from 24 hours right now.
So you mean that you have spent
last night.
You haven't slept for two nights.
I haven't. You know, I had a house before.
Yeah.
It was a busy housing, but This is what I would like to make anybody who have control of it clear.
Mm.
They give you a house, but it's not a house. They take your freedom out.
So the government give you a house here, but they take your freedom out.
Until you feel like it's not your home. Until you feel like you feel away, you go somewhere else.
So it is like a kind of a prison again.
Absolutely. Like, this is what it is. You will get your family to visit you from some other country.
Yes.
And then when they come to you,
yeah,
they will tell you that because of the rules that they make, they will tell you you cannot have no, doesn't matter what they do, you can't have nobody over, can visit you at this certain time or that time or this time.
So you mean that when they give you a house, they take away your rights for privacy?
They take your rights away.
They take your dignity away.
Your dignity away, absolutely. You know, like, you're a human. You cannot be isolated. Isolation is the greatest enemy.
The greatest enemy, yes.
For a human.
Mm.
you know, and you will find a good friend that you may not see even like for 10 years, or your family visit you.
Yes.
And they will simply say to you, because this is the rule, nobody can visit you. And this,
so they set up strict rules when they give you a house. See?
When they give you a house, they set up strict, very strict rules.
They cut that's off how, no cell phone.
That's how I give up on my house. That's how I ended up on homeless right now. And actually, I'm more pleasure. I'm more happy to be homeless and have my own rights, my own human rights.
Yes.
Than to be where I was before. Where they told me, oh, this is a house where I was isolated, where I was like, you know, stressed, where I was going all this struggle.
Yes.
You know, that's how I feel right now. I tell you, I swear to God, I'm more happy than I was. Even though right now I tell you, I did not sleep for 24 hours.
Yes.
I did not. I swear, my eyes are open from 24 hours. From 24 hours.
So what do you think about the Mayor Robert? He said that he's going to finish the issues of homelessness by 2015. There will be no homelessness in Vancouver.
It's deceiving, you know, it's deceiving. Even though whatever they say, even though they say they say there is a house, there is this, that, but the greatest thing for human is a dignity.
The greatest things for human is dignity.
It's a dignity.
So when they can give you a house, but they take away your dignity.
When they take your dignity,
you
rather to die even.
So it's like a kind of
you don't
suicide.
Want to, you want to run away. You want to run away. You want to go wherever. Even if you would sleep on a sidewalk, on a park.
Yes.
You want, that's where you have freedom.
So it's better to go to leave that house to go and live on the street.
Absolutely.
Because even the house they give you, there is no freedom.
No freedom. I tell you, like I mentioned.
Yeah.
Like I mentioned, you know what I mean? They will come to you like human, without like, you know, human without other human, we can't live.
The human without other humans, you cannot live.
You cannot live. So when you're told, you go to yourself. To that room,
yes,
and sit down there, sleep there.
Yeah,
you're going like, you know, you're going crazy.
You're going crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy. Even like, you know, human. We can't live without human. If you're, it's like prison. You're told like, you know, go in that room, sleep.
Yeah,
and nobody's gonna visit you. Nobody's gonna come to you. It's like a prison. They gave me TV. They gave me all that.
But nobody's allowed to come.
Yeah, what TV is to me? TV is an image.
It's an image, definitely.
It's not human.
It's not human.
It's not what my heart feels.
Yes.
Your heart doesn't. The image that I see in the TV, I do not know them. I don't know them in person. I don't know them. I don't even, you know, I'm just forced.
So they give you a TV. They give you chair, TV, and everything, and they say, this is it. No one is allowed to come in this building because we don't want you to be homelessness. We have given you this house, but nobody is supposed to come here.
That's right. That's
Do they give you telephone there inside?
No, I have no. I haven't had no telephone.
Are you married?
I'm not married.
So what if you want, maybe you have a girlfriend? Do they allow you to bring your girlfriend in that house?
No, right now, what I'm thinking about?
Yeah.
I gave up. I want just to be homeless like the way I am right now.
Yeah.
I want to, like, there is no life in here for me. What I want to do, I want to move to Alberta.
Yes.
Work hard, sacrifice for two years.
Yes.
And if I save up to 100,000, I want to move to back to my country.
Yes.
Start the business in there.
This is what we have been talking about so many times, that homelessness has made people to migrate from different parts of the country from one another. In Vancouver right now, there are a lot of people trying to move from Vancouver in search for employment in other areas. And not only that, some people leave from Vancouver to go to other areas because the city, it has become very expensive, an affordability to other people. it's become just higher and very expensive to other people to manage. Our brother here, he was brought back home from Africa, where I understand. Are you from Africa?
That's right.
Yeah, he's from Africa. And when he arrived here, he was given a house. But the house which were given for him, nobody is allowing to visit this person in that house. He claimed that the house is almost like a prison, where he has no freedom, where he's totally nothing. And then the final decision, this person seems to be very healthy mentally, and has a very good, is stable mentally, psychologically, just is very stable. And he decided that because of the issues of expensive city here in Vancouver, there is no government regulation is to maintain affordable houses. The only decision right now he has is to move from Vancouver just to just in such another comfortable place. So Mayor Robert, he deceived, he didn't stand on his promises.
He says I'm gonna get you all this homeless out of the city, blah blah.
Yes.
This that, and then he got some houses, but even those few houses that he got.
Yes.
He took human. He took our dignity out.
So the few houses he given you, he didn't.
Even the few houses, that there is still thousands homeless on everywhere. Sometimes I can't even find shelter. Like I said.
Yes.
Right now I'm up 24
so
hours.
So you cannot get a shelter.
You can't even get a shelter, and forget about housing.
Yes.
The housing, you know what I mean? The housing. If I struggle and I run away after a house and I run for 2 months, I might get some BC house or whatever.
Yeah.
But I do not want, because there is no dignity.
So there is no dignity in the houses being given to those homelessness people.
Yeah, there is no dignity. They say those people, they're crazy. They're crazy.
Mm.
They're crazy, so there has to be all this circulation.
Oh, so those, the government officials, those who provide houses for homelessness, they give the houses to homelessness thinking that the homeless people are always crazy.
Are already crazy.
That is the perception they have about the homelessness.
So that they make strict rules.
That's why they make strict rules, because they think that any homelessness person
is
crazy.
Think about it. Even if somebody is crazy, if his own people don't come to him, he will go more crazy.
He's go more crazy, definitely.
He will go more crazy. human is a human, whether they're crazy or not crazy.
Yes, a human is.
If they don't socialize, they will go crazy. You know what I mean?
Definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
So they say these people are crazy, so they can't have no people, so, they can't have all this kind of stuff.
Do you think all the people who are here, all of them at Hastings, are they mentally crazy? Are they just homelessness people? Do you think that any reason the government can't do anything to take people out of the street here? Because
somebody is crazy,
If
you tell them, if you outcast them, they will go more crazy. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But if you bring them closer to you,
They will
feel better, and they will start to love.
Definitely.
You know what I mean?
The more people we come closer to them here, the more they become friendly.
Friendly. The more they have more freedom.
What is your suggestion just to homelessness people here? What should the city do? What advice do you give to Mayor Robert to take out of the, to deal with the issues of homelessness?
I would say first of all, try to have a plan to make to make houses.
Yes.
For those vulnerable people.
Yes.
Who are suffering.
Vulnerable. Yes.
And after that, one thing I know for guaranteed.
Yeah.
Is if those people do not live in dignity.
Yeah.
As if they have living in their own family house.
Yes.
They will run away always.
So
dignity is very more important.
So you advise Mayor Robert that the only way to deal with the issues of homelessness, first to prepare houses where they are going to take these people.
And secondly, to have
dignity for these people.
To have freedom.
Freedom.
We say Canada is freedom.
Yes.
Why we all love Canada? Why have I migrated to Canada? What was the first point I migrated to Canada?
Is to get freedom.
To get freedom. To get where people where nobody else, where everybody
torture,
is same.
Yes. Where everybody is the same,
same.
No torture,
you
no conflict.
Like your, yeah.
Affordable, free food.
Everything. Where you have, like, you know, your freedom, your free expression.
Yes.
Where you have, like, you know, where you have no worries.
Mm.
You know
no
what I
worries,
mean?
Yes.
So, if fear starts from your house.
Yes.
The top, anything else is fruitless. Anything else does not work. Any other freedom
yeah.
is invisible to you.
Invisible, definitely.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
You know, so this is what I'm saying. Stephen Harper, I would say to him, you know, Canada have spent a lot of money, a lot of billions of money on a foreign stuff, like
yes.
on a war.
War.
On a things that's not necessary in here.
Yes.
While it has forgotten its own seriousness.
Thank you so much. That's a very good idea.
Yeah. I would say, please, look into your own, like, you know, they say, like, you know, when you solve your own problem,
yes.
then you can help others.
What about organizations who provide the food here? Like, we have seen you with some food
I
stuff.
I appreciate them a lot.
They
there
do,
is so much good people
yeah.
who bring food to here every day.
Yeah.
Where there is no, every day I come, I wake up,
yeah.
I do not have no money, I don't have nothing, I'm starving.
Mm.
But I walk on the blocks,
yeah.
there is always some organization. You know, in Vancouver, life
yeah.
is too expensive,
yeah.
yet you make little money.
Yes.
So anybody's dream
yeah.
will just die just like that.
Okay.
So what I was going to say,
yeah.
why I want to move to Alberta,
yeah.
I have a dream.
Yes.
I want, my dream is to invest, like, my dream is a business.
Yeah.
And business without investment,
yeah.
it's not going to work.
Okay.
So what I want to do,
yeah.
while I'm moving to Alberta,
yeah.
in Alberta, there
yeah.
is a great opportunity.
Yes.
You can work like, you know, a simple job.
And then you get more
and
money.
You can make up to $27. And
that's
if you sacrifice for 2 years, you
yes.
can make, you can save up to 80,000. And this 80,000 would just
this
simply be enough to invest in your business.
Okay, thank you so much, our brother, and we have heard a lot of things. Dear friends, thank you so much for your time you have given us to share with the,
yeah.
a lot of information here.
Yeah.
I wish we should meet again sometimes back, and I mean sometimes in the future,
yeah.
to discuss about the issues of homelessness.
Yeah.
Homelessness, as you have seen right now, many people here in the East End of Vancouver, Hastings, they are suffering, struggling, in hardships, there is no employment, there is a lot of... The government thinks that these people who live here on the street, that they are crazy. They are mentally disturbed. They are mentally uncomfortable, but we have managed to get the facts from one of our friends who have been a long time Canadian, who has been just living here on the street for almost 2 months, and has witnessed that there are houses that the government always give to people, but these houses... There is no dignity, there is no freedom of expression, there is no privacy, it's almost a prison. Secondly, lack of employment in Vancouver has made a lot of people to struggle, find themselves here on the street with the unaffordable houses. And finally, he said that the government here, most politicians, they give empty promises. They are too bombastic. They promise, but they don't implement what they have promised. He has given an example that instead of the government of Canada spending a lot of money on foreign conflict, it is better to deal first with the problems back home, and then from here, then we should go forward to look at things, problems outside Canada. Our homelessness guy said again that Mayor Robert made a commitment to deal with the issues of homelessness by 2015, but it is still a challenge. It is still a challenge, and he's calling everyone with responsibility to come up and the government stand on its promises to the citizens. Thank you so much. I have been Yasin Kiragamisago, President for Frontline Public Relations and Communications, Vancouver Downtown. Thank you so much and see you once again. Bye-bye.
Thank you, bro.